Hey guys, it's Lydia here from LA3D, and today I'm going to be reviewing this awesome TPU Hardness Plus Innovative Fill filament from Smart Materials. So, let's get started. Alright guys, so Smart Materials 3D sent me their awesome filament along with some PETG, which I will do another review on soon. But this filament is great, and unfortunately, when you hear TPU, you think rubber or like flexible, but unfortunately this filament is not. It is more of a ABS like filament, hint the hardness plus in the name. So unfortunately it is not going to be a flexible review, but other than that, this filament I've already printed with, it is great. It is a 250 gram spool is what it comes in, and as you can see, I've used a lot of it. I've done a lot of printing. I didn't do a lot of actual like big prints or anything, but I did a couple big prints, and then some test prints for the strength, so let's check those out and then we will finish or get on with the video. Alright, so first of all, I'm going to start off my very first prints with this filament. I thought it would be a good idea to print all of these brackets. Now they are strong in some spots, but the only downside is, for example, as you can see here, it is already snapped off. Now that is also my fault because of the orientation of the actual print. So I'll give you another example right here. This is broke off because it was printed in this orientation and then just snapped off testing. It does not show that, but again, as you can see there, very weak, and even in some other directions too. But I did print some other test prints with this filament, this dog bone here. Now this is about 80% infill, and as you can see, I gave it to my dog and he tried to destroy it. Now he lasted about an hour with this, so you can see how strong the layers were actually, and the only spot it broke were again on the layer lines here. Now I tried to print another one and this unfortunately was not successful, but as you can see, it is completely solid, and I was gonna have him try and chew this one up as well, just because the difference would be the percentage, and as you can see, this is completely full, and this was only at about 85%, as you can kind of see the infill in there. But unfortunately it did not print successfully, so I could not try that out. But just knowing that my dog took about an hour to destroy this, that shows how tough it actually is, even though with these prints it didn't show, just because of the position or the orientation of the print. If I would have printed it this way, maybe it would have been a little stronger, but unfortunately in some spots it wasn't. But as you can see, even there too, it's not very strong. But again, I could have put more infill on this, but I will be doing a lot more testing with this TPU filament for a lot of stronger projects. So next, moving on to this big reptar head. Now this is about 230% scaled, and I just cut his body off on the build plate so that only his head printed. And as I mentioned earlier, this TPU was kind of like a ABS filament. As you can see, there's multiple spots of cracking. And it was very actually hard to print. This was about a 16-hour print and I left it overnight. It didn't actually warp because I did leave a raft on it, but unfortunately, as you can see here, there's lots of gaps, and I did actually have to glue this thing up here because it did break. But again, just like on these, the layers were very, very weak, not because of the infill, but just because of the filament it is. So if you want to use this filament, definitely make sure you have the type of enclosure for it. But I will be doing another video on filling and sanding and painting this. But this filament, I mean, I printed multiple other things with it. I do not have them now. They were for some customers of mine. And it printed very nicely. Just depends on what kind of infill you have and just the type of model. So other than the cracking and everything, all the layers are really smooth. It is a little bit opaque because it is the natural color. With the support was easy to remove, but unfortunately I lost some teeth, or they just didn't form correctly because of the support. But other than that, this filament, I just actually like the plain color. It gives you some neutral, and if I printed it right, or when I print it right for certain things, it will be very strong. One more time, this is the Reptar. This is compared to my head. It is actually pretty decently big. I wanted to do a cool project with this guy because I already made his whole body. Just, I think it would look really cool, and another project with that will be coming later. Again, I hope you guys enjoy this video. Thank you so much if you are here at the end of the video. Thanks so much for sticking around as a subscriber, even though I've been gone for a couple weeks. I've been very busy and school is almost out, so hopefully I will be cranking out more videos this summer. Once again, there will be a delay in August, but other than that, hopefully we will be getting videos out. They might not be coming out week after week, but I will try to get out as much as I can. And there will be always updates on Twitter and Instagram too, just to let you know. Again, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.